Letitia Dean became the nation's sweetheart in EastEnders, and again last year with her stupendous performance in Strictly Come Dancing, and that's going to come in mighty handy as she treads the boards this...
You carry on, it's not my link, I can eat while you talk.
As she treads the boards this summer in the new stage revival of Disney's tremendously popular high school musical. First the show where Letitia put her heart and soul into dancing.
She is an actress. She needs to perform.
Miss Drama Queen, you're getting there.
Thank you. Possible dream to fight the unbeatable foe.
I've never seen you looking more lovely.
Yes.
A real star turn. It was a beautiful waltz, well executed.
To try when your arms are...
I really loved it. The whole vibe of today, really.
Your best dance to date.
Yes.
Well done.
She has improved incredibly.
The ballroom reborn, my darling.
Letitia's here now.
Good on you.
Yeah, you took it really seriously. Your little face.
Oh,
every
I know.
Week.
Your little face.
My little face. Oh, it was a tough job for me, that one. Yeah. I loved it, but it was, you know, it was absolutely. Yeah. But I mean, off stage, you know, obviously it wasn't like that. But I personally felt that they were quite good with their criticisms because they were generally very constructive, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, I think, you know, the whole nation now knows that Latin is not my thing. My hips just do not move that way. And I tried and tried.
But did you find it made you incredibly fit?
Yeah, absolutely. I think you've got to have quite a lot of stamina, haven't you, for that kind of thing. And then I went on to do the arena tour as well. Yeah. And I think I got through about 50 jives.
Jeez. We'll talk about this new production after this forthcoming break, but is there much moving and dancing in for you, for the teacher that you play?
Compared to Strictly, I would say a little light movement.
Really?
Yeah. But it's quite funky, which is another thing that's not my forte, but because I'm playing, you know, the drama teacher, I don't have to sort of...
Well,
look, I'm 15.
Before we just get onto that, because that's important, this is a tradition we have with all ex-EastEnders cast, and in fact, current EastEnders cast. Can we bring the board on, please? Thank you.
No.
We've got Albert Square on the board. Have you not done this with us before? We give you a little gat gum. I'll look it for you. And all you have to do is...
I wear glasses now, so this is going to be fabulous.
Take the gum and you squeeze the handle nice and hard. It's got a bullet in it.
Oh.
And wherever it lands on the board, let me angle it around a bit more, wherever it lands on the board, that's you've got to tell us a story about something that happened in real life in EastEnders. Just squeeze. I'll tell you where it went.
Well done.
It went to Mitchell's Autos. That's what it bounced off on.
Oh, Mitchell's Autos.
Any anecdote about Mitchell, in real life, about Mitchell's Autos?
Oh, I remember once actually doing a scene with Ross Kemp and Steve McFadden. And, of course, they've got I don't know what you call it, where they work as mechanics, where the car is, and there's a big hole in it. Yeah,
the pit.
I fell down.
Did you?
Rather beautifully, yes.
You mean you weren't meant to fall down?
No.
I see.
I just got so into the scene, and I went, ooh, slipped on my...
Did you fall sideways, backwards, forwards?
I think a very ungainly angle, really. I'm sure it's YouTube somewhere.
When did you last appear in it, EastEnders?
Gosh, you know, I can't remember. I think 3 years ago.
3 years ago, yeah. Do you watch it?
I have dipped into it now and again. It's funny because I don't know a lot of the people that... Shall I put the gun?
Yeah, put the gun down, Letitia. Just put it down.
Yeah.
Okay, go on.
I don't know a lot of the people are in it now. But, yeah, I still dip into it.
Yeah.
And I'm sure that my friend June Brown's just become an OBE.
Oh,
yes, that's
of
right.
Course.
She did. Yeah.
Got
well
done. Yeah.
So thrilled.
Congratulations to her. She's well done, June. Okay. As you can see, Letitia's back with us. Poised to take the stage in High School Musical, the hottest show in town, when it opens very soon. Is it next week?
July. 28th of June.
28th of June, okay. And in this clip from the movie, her character, which is the teacher Ms. Darbus, is giving the last class of the summer term.
The future greets you with its magic mirror, reflecting each golden moment, each emboldened choice.
Dude, Ms. Darbus has snapped her cap.
Dude, you're actually listening?
With poignant clarity. There was that unforgettable summer of dinner theater where I was the only actress to understand all the roles in the entire season's repertoire.
Summer.
Yeah. great.
She's camp, Miss Darvis,
yeah,
isn't she?
Yeah,
I
yeah.
love her.
Yeah, and actually, we've got some stills of you, actually, as you're appearing in rehearsals, and it is amazing. The character is very much true to form, isn't it? The glasses, the upswept blonde hair, all the rest of it.
Because when I first checked it out, I thought, I don't look 50, do I?
Yeah.
Well, you don't. Well, look, I mean... I've not seen it. I've not seen the film because our kids are just a bit too old to,
take,
you know, because they're in their 20s now. So tell us about it, about the stage version. What's the story?
Well, it's pretty much like the film version, really. I mean, the great message in this musical is that it tells children, really, that they can be whoever they want to be. You know, they're all individuals. You know, you don't have to be called to...
Yeah.
You have to be in the same gang and all of that business. So it's got a lovely message.
But is it basically about we're doing a show here now? Is that what's the story?
Yeah, a little bit. It's a little bit, I suppose, like a modern-day Greece, but with a much better...
More innocent Greece, isn't it? And it's just the sheer joie de vivre and energy of it, and of these kids who are all sort of dancing together and everything, yeah. Now, you're actually, aren't you... There's a tie-up with Great Ormond Street, isn't there? Certainly for the opening night.
Yeah, on July the 5th, we're having a big gala night with Ormond Street, which would be wonderful.
Because they're looking for sort of rebuilding and all sorts of things, aren't they? So it's helping that.
Oh yeah, absolutely. It's just going to be such a fabulous event.
Well, we've got a bit of footage from the American version of the stage show that you're doing, and just looking at it here, you're going to be absolutely exhausted at the end of each night. I mean, you must be losing pints of water through your pores. Yeah.
I'm certainly drinking a lot of fluids at the moment. Yeah, it's such a high energy show. It really is.
So after this, I mean, because you've been really busy, as you say, you did the tour after Strictly Come Dancing.
Yeah.
Now you're doing this. After this, presumably you're going to have a bit of a rest.
Oh,
I think
I'm going to need to lie down. Absolutely, after this. Yeah.
I'm sure it'll go really well. How long will the run be? How long will it be on for?
We open 28th of June, as I said, and we close on August the 1st. So it's fantastic because it's such an upbeat musical. So it's perfect timing for the school holidays. It's at the Hammersmith Apollo, which is a massive venue, 3,500 seaters. But everybody has a great view. That's the joy of that theatre.
I've been to the Apollo many times. It's got a really good venue. What happens if you sprain an ankle? Do you have an understudy? You can just come on at a...
Yeah.
And is she just understudying you, or does she do understudy another?
She's just understudying me, yeah.
Right.
Yeah,
so what is
that? She's doing great.
So what is she, the stand in the wings?
I mean, hopefully
watching?
I won't break my ankle, Richard. Could be some sabotage.
Well, a broken leg was it Victor Spinetti, you know, the British actor, gave him his career. He was in, he was the understudy in the South Pacific. And the guy who was understudying broke his leg when he went on. Spinetti went on, and that was the beginning of a great career.
And if that happens to me, I'll go on and crutch it.
You would, knowing you.
Yeah, really well, and it's on at the Hammersmith Apollo from, do you say, July the 5th?
June the 28th.
June the 28th is the previews, and the official opening night is July the 5th. Okay, good luck with it.
Thank
Sounds
you.
Great.